everyone? Are we all okay? We're all ready for some Friday night yoga. I've missed doing my live classes. Have you all missed me? Or maybe not. Got anyone joining me? Good evening, Dawn. We got anybody else? Good evening, Liz. Are you okay? Good evening, Carol. Good evening, Jenny. Okay. Well, back on screen is very strange in comparison. Obviously, I've been seeing people this week, which has been really nice. So face-to-face has been fab. Hopefully, a few more of you might come to class soon, fingers crossed. For me, it's quite nice. The room, the studio, we're only having 12 people in it, so it's quite small groups. It's really nice and spacious. So it's actually quite nice to teach in, actually, to be honest. And it's all gone really well this week, so fingers crossed, hopefully a few more of you may come shortly. It'd be nice to see you all face to face. But however, tonight we're doing online yoga, prepare ourselves for the weekend. So if you want to lay down onto the mat, roll the shoulders, allow the palms to face the ceiling and just close your eyes. And we're going to start to think about relaxing from the head, working all the way down to the toes. Allow your bodies to release. Clear your minds. Any thoughts, any worries, any stresses that you may have going on right now, anything that might distract you during the class, try and take all those things away and instead replace with nice, calming, relaxing thoughts. So try not to let your mind wander. I want you to really keep that focus just purely on yourselves. Bringing your awareness and your focus to the breath, to the inhales and the exhales. Breathing in through your nose and breathing out. Feeling the cool air as you breathe in and the warm air as you breathe out. Just allowing the body to relax, allowing the minds to clear. Nice calming, relaxing thoughts. And just when you're ready, I want you to open your eyes. And I want you to roll onto your right side and very slowly bring yourself into a cross-legged position. Or you can come into half lotus, that's bringing one foot on top of the other leg. Or you can sit exactly how you feel you want to sit. So, once again, close your eyes. We're going to focus on breath. We're going to do a little bit of breath practice. So we're going to breathe in through the nose nice and deeply. And breathe out through the nose nice and deeply. So we're not rushing this breath, we are enjoying every moment. Start to feel your belly expand as you're breathing in. And as you're breathing out, release the belly and draw the belly button back towards your spine. And again, as you're breathing in, we feel the expanse of our bellies rising and then falling as we breathe out. So on the breath out, expand into the belly, expand into the rib cage, and then as you're breathing out, release the air from the ribs, and once again the belly button draws back. Breathing in, filling the belly, filling the ribs, chest is going to rise. Breathe out, release. Start to feel where the air is going. I want the air to go into the back of the body. So breathing in, belly expands, ribcage expands, chest raises, and the air goes into the back, so into the back. So using the whole of the body in your breath, and then as you're breathing out, release. Just open your eyes. Take a breath in, raise the arms up. Exhale, bring the hands down to the sternum. Inhale to lift. Exhale to open. Inhale to raise up. Exhale, bring the hands to the sternum. Inhale to lift. And again, lateral flexion. Lift. Bring the right arm down, lengthen a little further. Feel through the side of the body. And then just turn the head to look towards the arm. And lift on the other side. So we come over the head and rotates. And lift. Bring the left hand to the right knee. The right arm comes forwards. We rotate and the head follows. So on our evening yoga sessions, we're concentrating on relaxing the body. We don't want to be too energetic in the class. We want to really prepare our bodies for the evening, to relax the bodies, to calm our minds. And release. And on the other side, the hand to the knee. The arm comes forward, the arm opens, and the head follows. And again, the crown of the head, we're lifting up towards the ceiling. Just releasing. Bring the soles of your feet together. The hands either onto the ankles, wrapped around the two big toes, or the hands behind and the bottom lifts. Again, depending on your shoulders and on your wrists and how you feel. Take a few breaths. Don't hold the breath. That constant breath flow. Releasing down, extend the legs out to the front. Drawing the toes back, the arms are going to lift. And we're going to reach forward. So again, feel the length. Hands can go onto the shins if you prefer. alternatively by the side of the head. So it's a length. So I want you to feel a length into your spine as well as a length into the legs. So we're reaching forwards. And I want you to reach forwards as opposed to down. Bring the hands to the toes and lift the chest up. We're lengthening up to the ceiling. And release. Bring the hands behind. Come up into your plank, your reverse plank. It's either a full reverse plank or you have a tabletop option. Still drawing the hips up towards the ceiling. Still lifting as high as you can, but just a different option. See what you feel would suit you best. And then just releasing down, bringing the legs around to the right side. Let's come into a four-point kneel. The wrists under the shoulders and knees under the hips. We take an inhale. On the exhale, into the cat. So we're going to round, nod and tilt. Draw the belly in. Exhale into the cow. The bottom is going to lift, the head is going to lift. And once again, round, nod and tilt. Draw the belly button up towards your spine. Exhale into the cow. The head raises, the bottom lifts. Once again, exhale into the cat. Round, nod and tilt. Drawing that belly button in. Feel what's happening into the spine. Exhale into the cat, to the cow, the bottom and head both breath. We come back to neutral. Now I want you to take it into child's pose. So you're going to sit back into child's pose. Bring the head down onto the mat and just allow the body to lengthen. I want you to take a few breaths and notice where the breath is going. So the breath is going into the back of the body. Now from here, I want you to roll up through your spine to a kneeling. So you're going to roll through the spine, so stretching out. And coming up into a kneeling position. Place the hands into the small of the back and take it into a little back bend. Squeezing the glutes. Lifting up. We take it to a lateral side bend. We lift the arm, we come over. So it's a little bit more challenging when we're on the knees. So when we're standing or when we're seated, we've got much more stability. We inhale and exhale over to the other side. So again, we go for that lateral flexion. Keep the bicep next to the ear. Really feel that length that you're creating through the side of the body. I want you to lift and then take yourself back into your child's pose. So again, we're gonna come down into the mat. We're going to feel the length into the spine. Let's have a few breaths. Taking the air into the back of the body. Let's roll up, curl through the spine. Come back into that kneeling position. This time, take the hands behind. We clasp the hands, and again, we come down. So we come into that back bend. The arms are straight. The eyes are focused up. Squeeze the bottom and lift. We go over to lateral side bend, lift the arm up and come over. Lift on the other side. right arm is going to reach for the right heel. And the left arm lifts and the hips push forwards and the bottom squeezes. Lifting and on the other side. Left arm to left heel, right arm lift. Push the hips forward, squeeze into the bottom. And then lifting up. And once again, come back into the child's pose. We're going to do another round. So again, reaching forwards, take a moment to have a breath. Breathing into the back of your body. If you start to now peel round up through the spine, so we're curling, so you're getting that stretch into the back, clasp the hands and come down and lengthen. Lift. Come into that lateral bend. Lifting on the other side, that lateral bend. Right arm, right heel, left arm lifts. Push the hips forward, squeeze into the glutes. Lift, other side, left to left, right lift. Well done. So the right leg steps out to the side. The foot is flattened, we go into that gate pose. So again, we're going into lateral flexion. So the hand is going to slide down the leg and that left arm comes over. And just notice how that stretch really increases. Again, a few breaths. And really lifting up out of the ribcage. Side, the leg steps out, the foot flattens, and we come over and we lengthen. And again, we're lifting up out of the ribcage. Bring yourself back down to your child's pose. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Coming up, we come forward and we drop the chest through to a hover. We push back and we come into child's pose. And it's a transition between the two, so breathing out to drop. Pushing back to be really strong in the upper body. So you're going to that dip, that tricep dip, lifting, pushing back, forwards, dip, lift, and back. We go for one more, we go to the dip, hold a moment, lift, push back. Come to all fours, we tuck the toes underneath, we come into our first down dog. So tuck the toes, push up, and just start with our pedals. So we push down one heel at a time, really lengthening through the back of the legs. We're bringing the chest back towards the shins. We're rotating the shoulders around towards the armpits and just pedaling through. drawing that belly in, and just feel that length. Push both heels down, lift up onto the toes, now bend the knees. Lift up, drop the heels. Up onto toes, bend the knees. Push the bottom away, lift up, drop down. Lift, bend the knees, push the butt away, lift up and drop down. Last time, so we lift, the knees bend, we lift and we just come down, push the heels down into the mat. Again, work on that chest coming back towards the shins and really feel that length you're creating into your spine. Come forwards to your plank. Drop your knees. Bring your chest forwards to your hover, your tricep dip. We come up to the sphinx. The forearms down, we feel length into the abdominals. Reaching forwards, opening into the chest. Coming down. We push back into that rest pose. Come to all fours, tuck the toes, we're going to come back up into that down dog. So we're going to lengthen, we're going to lift, we're going to feel what's happening into the back. We're going to bend our knees, we're going to take our gaze to face forwards. We're going to step one foot in, we're going to step the other foot. Lengthen, exhale the body to the legs. Let's have a lovely stretch down the back of our legs. We take a breath in, we lift. We open. We turn the right leg out. Place it onto the mat. Onto the calf. Or we lock. Hands come to that prayer position. Or above. We stand tall. Here. Let's take the right leg and we're going to step it to warrior one. Push the back heel, come forward. Imagine you've got your swords above your head. You're holding your swords in that warrior position. You're pushing that back heel down. Take a few breaths. Sound of the oceans you're breathing out. The front leg straightens. The arms come forward. We're going to reach. You're going to reach towards me, guys. Reach towards me. Come towards me. Now come down to your mats. So both legs are straight. The front leg is going to bend and the front leg is going to straighten. So again, it's a bend and a straighten. And again, bend that front leg, straighten it, bend, straighten. Go for one more. Now keep the legs straight. And work in this posture. Push the bottom back. Very slowly bring yourself back up to standing. We come back into that warrior one. Bring the arms around. Interlace the fingers. We come over. Bring the arms overhead. Front leg is straight. Warrior two. Look out of the middle finger. Straighten the leg. Exhale, bend. Straighten. So it should be your left leg that's forwards, and that's straightening and bending. Straighten. Exhale to bend. Inhale to straighten. Exhale, you bend and stay. Take a few breaths. Be strong in your warrior position. We come into our side angle. The arm comes overhead. The other arm on the knee. Shall we bring our hand down to the side of the inside of the foot of our left hand? Now the right arm is lifted up to the ceiling. We're going to bring it around. We're going to feed for our thigh, our opposite thigh. Bring the shoulder back, guys. Do what you can, do what you can. Release, arm lifts. Come back, warrior two. Cartwheel over. Lunge. Back to that lunge. Now, bring the left hand to the left foot, the inside. Step the leg back to your plank position. Drop your knees, counter pose. Let's take it to child's pose. We're going to rest. We are going to rest here for a moment. We're going to breathe. We're going to enjoy the chance to breathe. Where is your breath going? It's going all the way into the back of your body. Come to all fours. Tuck your toes, push back into the down dog. Lengthen and lift. Let's bring our chest towards our shins. Lengthen and lift. Push back through the thighs. We bend the knees, cast your gaze forwards. We jump or we step. Inhale, we straighten those legs. Exhale, the body is coming close. Inhale, we rise. Exhale, we open. Shall we do it all on the other side? Let's. So, left leg is going to turn out. Either goes onto the mat, the calf, or we lock. Hands. Hands. We're going to stand tall. Challenge yourself. Close your eyes. See how that affects your balance. We're going to step that leg back to our warrior one. We're going to hold our swords up high. We're going to push that back heel down into the mat. Straighten the front leg. Come forwards to me. So you're reaching towards me. Through that screen, guys. Let's come down to the mat. So come forwards. If you can touch the floor, great. If you can't, just hover. You might find one side is slightly more challenging. Bend the knee and straighten. Bend, straighten, bend, straighten, bend, and straighten that leg and just take hold of here. Lifting up, warrior one. Hold your swords. Hands down, clasp overhead. Warrior two, straighten, bend, straighten, bend, straighten. Shall we hold, cast your gaze down the centre of your hand. Into that side angle with the arm up, the other arm onto the knee, and we will progress . Bring the hand down . Now the left arm is reaching up to the ceiling . The left arm is going to come around your back and feed for your right thigh . Bring the shoulder back. Again, do what's right for you. If you want to have the arm in the air, if that suits you better, then go for that. Release the arm lifts. Warrior two. Cartwheel. Lunge. Hand to the inside of the foot. Step it back. Plank. Drop your knees down. Cross your legs at the back and come over onto your bottoms. Lift. The toe of the chest is going to lift. Breathe. And release. Let's bring the soles and feet together. Place the hands either behind or on to the ankles or even wrapping fingers around the big toes if you prefer. Then opening the hips and opening the groin. Let's see those knees go down. Close your eyes if you want and just take some nice breaths and really start to think about relaxing and cooling the bodies. Pause. very slowly, not too rushed. Lengthen the legs and then draw the right knee in. Don't force the knee, let it go to where it wants to go. Close your eyes and enjoy the stretch. Feel it into the hip. Feel it into the glute. Just release down. On the other side, draw the knee in. Don't force it, just draw it in. Take a few breaths. Enjoy this moment. Arms behind the head. Stretch from the fingers to the toes. Lengthen through the body. Draw the belly button down. Feel the spine stretch. Feel the whole body stretch. Feel the whole body lengthen here. Bring your arms down by your sides while your shoulders. Allow your palms to face to the ceiling. Close your eyes. Let's feel our whole body sink down into the mat. The whole body release, the whole body relax. Release any areas of tension that you may have. Completely let your bodies go. Let them sink down into the mat. Fingers a stretch. Feel the palms tighten, feel the fingers lengthen, and then just release. Feel your jaw soften. Feel the tongue fall into the base of your mouth. Feel your eyeballs soft against your eyelids and let them drop into the back of the head. Let the head fall. Release. Spine. Back to the centre on the other side. Just let that head fall. Let it relax. And release. Just take that moment for yourselves. That moment to relax. That moment to release. And this might be the only time during the day you get to relax. The only time you get for yourselves. So enjoy, savor every moment. And then just when you're ready, just open your eyes. And very slowly just roll onto your right side. And then very slowly we bring ourselves up to seated. Into our cross-legged position, or just a comfy seated position. Let's take a breath in. through your nose. Breathe out through your mouth. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Open your eyes. Breath in, raise the arms. Bring the hands down to the sternum. Namaste. Thank you so much, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this evening's yoga practice. I will be here on Sunday morning. I will let you know the time. So Sunday morning's class will be either a weighted class or a high impact cardio class. I haven't fully decided. I'm thinking more likely around about the 9 o'clock time for Monday. If any of you are coming in the morning, I am actually full in the morning, so that's great news. I'm really happy about that. So if any of you are coming in the morning, I will see you in the morning. If not, please join me on Sunday. I will put a post out tomorrow as to what the time is when I've confirmed it and to what I'm doing, but it will be online. So hopefully you're going to join me then. See you soon, guys. Enjoy the Friday evening.